My name is Ryan Hartigan from Econ Technologies, the creators of ChronoSync and ChronoAgent. This is the second part of a two-part series where we take a look at the restore feature that has been significantly overhauled in version 4.3 of ChronoSync. This second part will deal with restoring from the archive panel of a synced document. This would be done when restoring synced items that have either been replaced or deleted during a sync. This screencast assumes you have ChronoSync installed and are running a previously saved and run synced document. If you wish to learn how to configure and run a sync, please check the screencast in the link below. Without further ado, let's get started. Begin by launching ChronoSync and opening your saved sync document. You'll notice that I have sync deletions with move to archive set, and that I have archive replaced files enabled. The first option moves all items deleted during a sync to the archive. The second option moves all items replaced during a sync to the archive. Either one must be enabled for archiving to take place during a sync. In part one of this screencast, I had accidentally deleted some files on my source target. Restore was easy because I had a direct backup copy available. However, if I had run a synchronization before the restore, my backup copy would have been deleted since I have sync deletions enabled. Having delete to archive enabled is my safety net against such data loss. With this option enabled, my deleted files aren't really deleted, but moved to a special part of the hard drive called the archive. To find the deleted files, I switch to the archive panel. What is displayed is a list of all files within the archived items folder. The archive contains all files that have been deleted or replaced in your destination target as part of a normal sync operation. It provides a safeguard against accidentally losing valuable files as part of a sync. Locate a file or folder to be restored. You may notice several versions of the same file with version numbers. The highest version number is the most recently added file. Also shown are when the file was archived and when it was modified. You can sort items in the archive panel by the version number or archive date to group batches of archived files together, making it easier to identify and select which version of the file you want to restore. Right-click the item and select the restore option. A sheet will appear with options on how to proceed with the restore. Here I'm restoring from the archive on my right target, which is the destination for a simple left-to-right backup. These are files that have been replaced over the course of weeks of running this backup. My first option allows me to restore the selected files back to the left target, which contains my original files. I would choose this, for instance, if I modified my master files, but then decided that my changes were no good and I wanted to revert to a previous version. The second option allows me to restore to the right target, which is the destination of my backup. It allows me to replace the primary backup copy of a file with an older copy, but it does not overwrite the working copy of the file on my left target. This option is generally not used very much. Lastly, I can restore to a specific folder. This allows me to choose a destination, and then I can manually go through the restored files and determine what to do. This is useful in cases where I may simply want to extract a piece of information, such as a name or phone number, that I may have deleted from the original file on my source target. This is the safest and most common method of restoration. In this example, however, I just want to restore to a previous version of these documents, so I choose left target. With the target chosen to restore to, it's time to click the restore button and wait for the restoration complete sheet to appear. If you are restoring to a folder that contains the item you're restoring already, a duplicate file sheet will appear asking you how to proceed. Finally, a restoration complete sheet will appear with details on how the restore finished. If you have any questions regarding ChronoSync or ChronoAgent, please visit our website at econtechnologies.com.